The Jam have announced they're breaking up. The group are led by singer and songwriter Paul Weller. At 24, he's become something of a spokesman for the new Beat Generation. He's pronounced on politics, life, and music to fans so enthusiastic to receive his message that they've come from America and Japan to hear him. We went to meet Mr. Weller just before he finally unjammed The Jam.
The band is amazingly successful. Why stop now?
Because I feel we've achieved enough, you know. I think we've done all we can do as the three of us. I think it's a good time to finish it. I don't want to drag it on and go on for, like, you know, for the next 20 years doing it and become nothing, mean nothing, end up like all the rest of the groups, you know. I want this to count for something. I want everything I've done, you know, the last 5, 6 years to count for something.
What could it count for?
It strikes me that after people get over the age of, like, 25, once they get their house and their wife and their kids, you know, ideals don't mean nothing, you know what I mean? All that matters, you know, I mean, it's not always their fault, it's just the environment, but all that really seems to matter is just that it's keeping that situation going, you know what I mean? I think it's important to believe in something in this life, because, like, it's such a flimsy sort of system we got and a flimsy kind of culture, you know what I mean?
How would you like to see the system change?
I would like to see all those people with power, who have always had the power and the wealth, I would like to see them done away with, and I would like to see the power and wealth distributed properly, you know. I don't like the way it's centralised.
Is music going to help in that?
No, I don't think music could overthrow it or change it directly, but I think it helps in terms of communicating to different people. I think it's, you know, because it's the only real kind of culture that young people have got, you know.
Isn't it a bit easy for you, though? I mean, you've done very well out of it all. It's very easy for you to spout this stuff. A lot of people say, aren't you being rather self-righteous?
I think you've got to try and work at what you're best at, you know. So that's what I just intend to do.
As the leading light in the Jam, your future seems to be quite well mapped out.
Well, so everyone keeps saying, but I don't really see that, you know. The Jam is a group, you know, regardless of me being portrayed as the front man. A lot of our fans really think of it as just, you know, as the group, and just as the three of us. So I don't actually think it's going to be that easy.
What about the other two? As I say, your future career does at least look fairly played out. What about them? Some people are saying, aren't you dumping them?
Well, that's a lot of crap, isn't it? You know what I mean? It's a group. We work together as a group, you know. It's not my responsibility, you know.
Are they happy about the breakup?
I wouldn't say they're happy about it, no. But, you know, it's just something which I felt inside me. You know, you just got to go by instinct, and I felt it was the right thing to do. I thought about it. It wasn't as if I just sort of made my mind up overnight. Well, that's the nice thing about it at the moment for me anyway, because it's the first time for years which I haven't had any definite plans, or, you know what I mean? It's just like, I don't know what's going to happen, you know, which I'm quite enjoying at the moment, because it's like I said, it's the first time for 6 years it's been like that. So I'm just going to enjoy that for a little while. It's just to see how it goes, you know, take as it comes. Whatever I do, I want to be successful, otherwise to me there's no point in doing it, you know.